Hi everyone, my name is Sienna. In this video, we will learn about the basics of image tracking. By the end of this video, you'll be able to build a simple AR app that tracks an image and spawns a 3D object on top of it. We will be using AR Foundation 5 and Unity 2021.2 and above. Please watch my basics AR video first to know how to set up a new AR project. In a new scene, remove the main camera, then add XR origin and AR session. Right-click, XR, XR origin, then right-click again, XR, AR session. Then make sure that both of the transform is reset to zero. In XR origin game object, add AR track image manager. This is to add the image tracking feature. The Realize library is the library of images that will be detected. We need to create reference image library for this. To create it, right-click, create, XR, reference image library. I'll be using the default name. The reference image library is a set of reference images. Import the image you want to use to Unity. Then in the reference image library, click add image. Drag and drop the image. You can use any name. There is no check for duplicate name conflicts, so you can use the same name for multiple images. But it will be better to give them a different name so it's easier for you to differentiate them. The specify size variable is to specify the physical size you expect the image to be in the real world. This will be in meter. You must enable this for iOS. But for Android, it will be good to also enable this as it will improve the image detection performance. Changing one dimension will also automatically change the other dimension based on the image aspect ratio. Enable keep texture at runtime if you need access to the source texture at runtime. It will also increase the build layer size. If you enable this, to get the image texture in the script, use as a reference image the texture. Drag and drop the created reference image library to the serialized library variable. Maximum number of moving images is the number of moving images to track simultaneously. This requires more CPU resources, so only increase the number if necessary. If the image is just being placed on the table, it doesn't count as moving. Example of moving images is when the image is being held by the user as they move their hands around. Track image prefab variable is the prefab that will be instantiated when an image from the reference image library is detected. You can leave it as null if you have your own way of spawning the prefab. This is the prefab that I'll be using. Drag and drop your prefab to the track image prefab variable. You can test this project in the editor by using XR simulation. Please watch my XR simulation video for more detail. If you build the project now, you'll be able to spawn the prefab on top of the track image. Please go to ArrorCore and ArrorKit documentation to know their limitation and best practice, especially on choosing the best image. The link to their documentation will be in the description below. Some of the limitations include it can only track up to 20 images simultaneously. It will also not simultaneously detect or track multiple instances of the same image. This means that it cannot track more than one same image at the same time. If you previously used Vuforia, they have a rating score to know the image quality. Although they don't have this for ARKit, but you can also get a rating score in ARCore. I will create a separate video on how to do this. Please like and subscribe and check my Patreon. If you have any question or suggestion, feel free to ask in the comment or in the Discord channel. Thank you for watching.